Don't let the world, don't let people tell you that you're no good. Amen. Well, welcome everybody. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Yes. Feliz Día de Pascuas. Pastores Jose y Patricia, we want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church out of the Big Ben. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Bienvenidos a la Iglesia del Nuevo Comienzo. We're excited. We're celebrating the resurrection of our Lord. Amen.
Yes.
And I'm getting way ahead of myself, but guess what? This world says there's lots of gods that come and gone. And they're still in their brain.
Yeah.
Our God
yes.
is a risen Savior.
Amen.
He's a risen God. Amen.
Yeah.
He rose. Amen. And they've got proof, but they can't explain it. Amen. But we know we serve a living God. Amen.
Yeah.
So praise God. Prepare yourselves to receive. Today's message is He is risen. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God. We want to welcome all those of you that are joining us by audio and video.
Yeah.
Bienvenidos a todos los que nos escuchan por audio y video. Prepárese a recibir lo que el Señor tenga para usted. Amen.
Yes.
So praise God. He's got something for you. He always has something for you.
Yes.
Amen. And we don't just celebrate once a year.
That's
we
right.
celebrate His resurrection yes. daily. Amen. Because if it wasn't for Him,
Amen.
You wouldn't be around.
That's right.
Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
So come and be blessed. Amen. And leave changed. Don't ever leave the same.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. Let's give. I'm excited. I don't know about
Amen.
You. Happy Easter to you. Happy Resurrection Sunday. And it is a day of celebration.
Yes.
Amen. It's not a day to be sad.
That's
you
right.
know what? It would have been a sad day if we knew He died and never rose back.
Oh, right.
But it's a day to celebrate.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. You know, I don't know about you, but when I know a brother or a sister or a mother or father has gone home and I know that they were Christians, that they were in love with their God, you know, I always go to the family and let them know, praise God, I'm celebrating with you.
Yes.
Your folk is in heaven.
Yes.
I'm celebrating their home going.
Amen.
They're going back home. Amen. The Bible
Amen.
Says that we're not just in this world. We're passing through.
Hello.
Amen. We're not, this is not our home. We're passing through, but we're going home. When we go home, we're going to heaven. Amen. I don't know about you, but we're just passing through.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
This earth is not my home.
That's right.
Amen. Heaven is my home. And we're just passing through, and we're just doing a work for God.
Yeah.
Amen. You, wherever you happen to be, are sharing the good news of the gospel.
Yes.
Amen. You're somewhere going somewhere to happen for somebody,
yes.
releasing somebody, touching somebody, and saying, you know what? I serve a risen Savior.
Yes.
How many of you can say that?
Yes.
Not too many can say that. I serve a risen Savior.
He's in the world.
Amen. And you know, He's in the world
yes.
today. And you know where He is? He's in you.
Yes.
And you're going somewhere to happen for somebody.
Yes.
Releasing
yes.
them. Letting them know about your God. Say, hey, I want you living God.
Yes.
Yeah, praise God. And you know what? He don't turn nobody down.
That's right.
But you have to confess it with your mouth.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You have to confess Him as Lord and Savior. Receive Him. Amen. And He never turns you away, you know.
Right.
You know, He's just doing a bow face. I like those about faces. We learn how to do that in the military. You got to learn how to do it about face. We messed up the first few times, you know. But after that, we got to be experts.
Yeah.
But you know what? When you end up doing about face from the world to Jesus, He'll receive you with open arms.
Amen.
And you know what He'll say? He says, I forgive you. I forget the past. So it's time to get busy for Him.
Yeah.
Amen. It's time to get busy because I've got a mission for you.
Uh-huh.
Amen. The world... The enemy will tell you, you're not good enough for this job. You're not good enough for this. You're not qualified for this. God says, I've already qualified you.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
You're going somewhere to happen for me. I qualified you. And you can do all things through Christ who strengthens
Amen.
You. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you know what? You study for all this, but when you get up here, it just comes out a little different.
Amen.
So praise God. Amen. The Bible says He's not here. He's risen. Amen. Before we get too far ahead,
yeah.
grab your swords.
Yeah.
And let's say this and say it like a man, church. Amen.
Yes.
So praise God.
Hallelujah.
This is my Bible. If you don't have one, grab one
yes.
in the back. I am what it says I am.
Yes.
I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be taught the word of God. I boldly confess, my mind's alert, my spirit is receptive, and I'll never be the same in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know where it says I am, I have, I can do? You can put your name there.
Yeah.
Jose. Eh? I am what he says I am.
Yes.
Jose. He says I can have what he says I can have.
Uh-huh.
Jose can do what he says I can do.
Yes.
Amen. You can do these things. Amen.
Yeah.
This is your word. And you know what? You don't say God never talks to me and you never open his Bible
read
his word. Because he'll talk to you through his word and he'll show you all these things. Amen. He wants us to learn the word so you can get it in you and get all the fears out and let your faith grow so you can go somewhere to heaven and let the word of God come out of you to release somebody from the same thing I was in.
That's right.
The bondage I was in. Those things that I was in that was holding me back.
Yeah.
Amen. The only thing stopping me is myself.
Yeah.
Amen. So I have to find out what God thinks of me so that I can start seeing myself the way he sees me.
Yes.
He sees me a winner, a champion,
yes.
And that's what you are. Okay? The world has already beat you down, and people's already beat you down, and you're thinking that way. And you're saying, you know, the only thing for me is to just blow my head off. Well, you know what? That's not what God has for you. That's what the enemy wants for you. Amen. And you start thinking that way, but you know what the Bible says? Renew your mind with the word of God to what he thinks about you.
That's right.
Amen. And you renew your mind and get all the world out of there.
That's
amen.
Right.
And renew your mind of what the word of God has for you.
Jesus.
And you start thinking that way and walking that way and saying, hey, you know what? I was afraid of a devil. It's a defeated foe. Jesus already defeated him, beat him, and now I can do the same thing. I have authority I never used before. So now I'm going to use the authority he's given me.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Start using it, walking in that authority God has given you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
He didn't call you to be defeated. He called you to be a winner, a champion for him. Amen. And we're going to talk about our champion. Resurrection Sunday. That means he was resurrected. Amen.
Yes.
Woo. Praise God. He is not here. He is risen.
Yes.
Matthew 28:6 says, the angel said, first he said, why are you looking for the dead amongst the living?
Yeah.
He's alive, amen.
Yes,
but Matthew 28:6 says the angel said, he is not here.
Yeah.
For he has risen.
Uh-huh.
And he says, come see the place where the Lord lay.
Uh-huh.
Come see, it's empty.
Yeah.
Amen. It's not there anymore. So happy Easter Sunday. What else?
Yes.
Happy Resurrection Sunday.
Yes.
Keep going.
Thank you, Lord.
Give me another one.
Praise God.
Resurrection Sunday, the day that changed everything.
Yes, it
did.
It can change your life.
Yes.
Amen. Change your life. Amen. But you know what? Here's the thing. it's called relationship.
Uh-huh.
And you got to keep doing this on a daily basis. Otherwise, if you don't renew your mind with the Word of God on a daily basis, you'll fall right back into the same thing. You'll fall right back into the world. You'll fall right back into the same people that beat you down are going to be there again for you. Amen. It's time to get strong in the word.
Amen.
And not go there anymore. It's time to change partners, you know.
Thank you, Lord.
He wants to bless you. Jesus Christ, our Lord, is risen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Nobody else can say that except the children of God. Amen.
Amen.
So, praise God. This is awesome.
Thank you, Lord.
Ooh, listen. Jesus is the reason for the celebration of the Resurrection Sunday.
Yes.
Jesus is the reason for the Easter season.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
His blood, his life, he gave for us to be saved.
Yes, he did.
He paid a price. I wrote it here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, come on. We'll get to it. But you know, it goes like, he paid a debt he didn't owe.
Yes.
And I owe a debt I cannot pay. Amen. I owe a debt I cannot pay.
Yes, yes.
He died for you, and we're ignoring him.
Uh-huh.
Amen. He gave you everything to live a successful life, and we're ignoring it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to take care of me. It's time for me to get off the throne and put Jesus on the throne.
All right.
Amen. Keep him on the throne.
Yes.
Amen. And every time you feel like crawling back up there, you say, step back and say, you know, get on your knees, spend time with him, and say, forgive me, Father.
Amen.
And you know what? He'll forgive you.
Yes, he will.
People, world, never going to forgive you.
Mm.
And if they say that,
they're lying.
They lied. You know when the enemy is dying, huh?
Mm-hmm.
His lips are moving.
Yeah.
That's all the time.
Oh, praise God.
God is good.
Yes, he is.
Praise God. Here it is.
You,
it was right there. Thank you, Lord. He paid a debt he didn't know.
Yeah.
You know, the Father and the Son, they met in heaven. And the Father says, "Son, I'm up. Let's talk." He says, "I miss my people. I want my people back. And I'm going to send you to earth. And I'm going to sacrifice you." And the Son says, "Cool, Dad, I'll go." That's what I'm saying.
Right.
Yeah. So guess what? Listen, from the beginning, when he stepped out of heaven into this world, he knew he was going to be sacrificed.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Now, if you're sent on a mission somewhere, being a soldier, a lot of times we send on missions and we know we may never come back.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. As a child of God, you got to get yourselves ready, because when you walk out your door every morning, maybe your last time. But you know what, Father, I just spent time with you. Get yourself ready to go where he wants you to go. Amen.
Yeah.
I cover myself with the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
I'm under his protection.
Yes.
And go. Amen. I'm not afraid. He's not giving me a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So praise God. No matter what the enemy tries to bring, no weapon formed against me shall prosper.
No.
Amen. So praise God. I'm going out in no fear.
Yes.
I'm going to be an
praise
awesome,
God.
Great soldier for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So praise God. But you never know.
That's right.
Hallelujah. The four Gospels record the account.
Yes.
If you want to write it down, I'll go slow. But Matthew 28, chapter 28, verses 1 through 10. Mark 16, chapter 16, verses 1 through 14. Luke 24, chapter 24, verses 1 through 44. And John chapter 20, verses 1 through 31. And we're going to be reading from the book of John chapter 20. Amen?
Amen.
So he is not here. He is risen. Praise God. He defeated the enemy. He defeated the enemy. And he took the keys of death, hell, and the grave. Amen. Jesus left the earth. He walked into hell. He walked into hell and took the keys of death, hell, and the grave from the enemy. Amen. He took those people back. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Revelations 1:18 says, in the expanded Bible says, "I am the one who lives. I was dead, but I took. And behold, I am alive forever and ever, and I hold the keys of death, of the place of death, hell." Amen.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God, well, we're going to get to that in a few minutes, but God says he defeated death, hell, and grave. Death's final call, he would not obey.
That's right.
Amen. And they couldn't kill him until he surrendered himself to the Father.
Yes.
Amen. And then before he surrendered himself to the Father, he told him, "Father, forgive them. Don't hold this against them." Amen.
Amen.
And now you have an opportunity to ask Jesus to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Because of what Jesus did. He paid the price.
Yes.
He paid the price in full. Amen. He stepped out of heaven into this world and knew from the beginning that he was going to be sacrificed.
Yes.
If you knew that, would you go on your mission? If we knew we was going to die today, would you step out and do what you're supposed to be doing? Maybe not. So he's seated at the right hand of the Father, interceding for us. Romans 8:34 says, "Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore, is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us."
Amen.
So if you want to know what Jesus right now, he says, seated at the right hand of God. The right hand of God is a place of honor.
Yes.
It's a place of authority.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And he's interceding for us.
Yes.
He never has. He never will forget about you.
Yes.
He's still praying for us. Amen.
Amen.
Ephesians 1 and 2, excuse me, Ephesians 1:20 says, "Which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him."
Yes.
He seated him at the right hand in heavenly places. Amen. That's what he says. He's coming back to, went back to Father, and is seated him right there on the right side, a place of authority. Colossians chapter 3 and verse 1 says, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. These are scriptures that talk about where God, where Jesus is. He's at the right hand of God. Amen. Praise God. Acts 7:55 and 56. Acts chapter 7, verses 55 and 56 in the NIV. I just kind of threw this in there because now he's telling you that he is seated at the right hand of God. Now this is the only place that the Bible talks about Jesus standing.
Yes.
Jesus stood.
Yes.
He has a servant named Stephen. And Stephen was taken out and he was stoned to death.
Yes,
he was stoned to death for being faithful. But Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, looked up to heaven as he's being stoned, and he saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God.
Yes.
And verse 56 says, look, he's telling the people that are stoning him. He says, look, he says, I see heaven open, and I see the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. How would you like to be one of those throwing a rock? And then he's telling you, this is what I see. Uh-huh. He saw a vision. He says, I see the Father.
Yeah.
And I see Jesus standing at the right side of it. Ain't it amazing?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Ooh, praise God.
Lord.
So guess what? He's always watching out for us. Resurrection Sunday is not about the Easter money.
That's right.
Easter eggs or Easter baskets.
That's right.
It's celebrating the Lord Jesus Christ,
yes,
as he rose from the dead.
Yes.
Amen. So praise God. You know, gives us an opportunity to receive him,
yes,
as Lord and Savior. Yes. It's never too late. You know, don't say, well, you don't want to get enough of this world, and then when I get a chance, I'll receive it right before he comes back.
No.
Well, the Bible says you never know when he's coming
That's
back.
Right.
You never know when he's coming back.
Uh-huh.
You know? And I wrote this at the end, and I might say it again, but you know, the world tells us flu season is coming.
Yeah.
It tells us storm is coming.
Uh-huh.
And we go and prepare our houses.
Right.
We go and prepare our bodies, you know, for
yeah,
the flu season. We go and prepare ourselves for all these things the world is telling us is coming.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man, we caution, you know. We take all the precaution things, you know, like
yeah,
getting ourselves ready. But the Bible tells us he's coming back.
Yeah.
And we do nothing about it.
Right.
We just kick back and say, hey, you know, I'll just wait till the last minute, and then I'll just say, I receive you as Lord and Savior. Well, you never know when your life is going to be in danger.
That's right.
You
That's
never
right.
know when you're going to be gone.
That's right.
Whew. So praise God. Amen. I'll tell you a quick little funny here, and I'll just, anyway, it is a quick joke. But the Sunday school teacher was teaching the third graders, Jesus was crucified and placed in a tomb, and a great stone sealed the opening. Sharing the excitement of the resurrection, she says, what do you think Jesus' first words were when he came out of the grave? Out of that. And the little girl in the back, Mary raised her hand, she jumping up and down, and she says, ooh, teacher, I know. So the teacher says, okay, Mary, what did Jesus say when he came out? He says, ta-da!
Oh my God.
The resurrected Jesus was resurrected indeed, but I know he had more than ta-da to say. Amen. It's more than that. Amen. Ooh, hallelujah. The one, when Jesus rose, the enemies trembled. The enemies ran. Amen. And when they know that you're full of Jesus and you spend time with him and you're full of Jesus, guess what? When you wake up, the enemy says, I'm out of here. Boom, I'm gone. Says, submit yourself to God, resist the enemy, and he'll do what?
Flee
from you. He's not just going to walk slowly away from you. He says, he's going to flee, means quickly. I'm out of here. Praise God. Yee-haw. So I serve a risen Savior. His first words out of the grave was, ta-da. Believers can celebrate his resurrection.
Yes.
How? Daily.
Yes.
Not just yearly, but daily, on a daily basis. Yes. Hey, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You know,
yes.
I serve a risen Savior. Uh-huh. Thank you, praise God. Celebrate with an attitude of gratitude.
Yes.
Amen. Every day he tells you, I give you a new day. Rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Amen. This is up to you. He didn't say if the weather's fine. He didn't say if it's perfect, if conditions, everything is going good.
Yes.
If you feel like it, he says, I've given you a new day. Rejoice and be glad in it. You know, I've got the attitude, I've got the Jesus in me. And I'm going to rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Celebrate with an attitude of thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this new day. Hallelujah. I need these to let you know what that sign says back there. It says, each day is a gift.
Yeah.
Receive it with gratitude.
Yeah.
See that sign as you walk out on a daily basis.
Yeah.
Each day is a gift.
Yes, it
receive
is.
It with gratitude.
Yes.
Thank you. You
praise
know,
God.
Hallelujah. Well, what am I going to get in today? I'll tell you what I used to get into when I was in the world. Oh man, I'm going to get into some mess today. The people can't wait to say, thank God it's Friday. I can go get some in all kinds of mess. Remembering Jesus is the reason for celebrating this season. Amen.
Yes,
praise
amen.
God. Remember,
praise
he is
God.
Our living and victorious King.
Yes.
Remembering that he paid a price in full that he didn't have to.
That's
but
right.
He did anyway. Amen.
Yes, yes.
Ooh, hallelujah. Praise God. Let me see. Let me get another slide. Hallelujah. He is risen. Praise God. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he dies, yet he lives. John 11:25.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
God.
You know, even though they lay you down, you're going to rise again.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise
God. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Again, Matthew 28:6 says, the angel says, he's not here, he's risen.
Mm-hmm.
He says, come see the place where they laid the Lord.
Yes.
Where the Lord laid. And Mark 16:6 says, but he said to them, do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. Even the angel is telling them, I know who you're seeking. You're seeking Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified.
Yes. Right.
When you get crucified, you get real dead.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you are dead.
Yeah.
He is risen. He's not here. Mm-hmm. See the place where they laid him?
Yeah.
Now I got to tell you this. I also forgot to tell you this. I may not finish this sermon without crying. And it's okay. You know, when you're excited about God, he's going to show through you.
Amen.
Smile on your face. Tears in your eye.
Yeah.
Arms going up. Thank you. Or getting on your knees to just say, oh. And it affects us differently.
Mm-hmm.
Emotionally, it affects us differently. You might get on your knees. I might just raise my arms and say, thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
But don't forget to say that. Amen.
Amen.
I had a privilege while going through Bible school to visit the Holy Land, to visit Israel. I think Scott just came back from this year, last year.
I don't remember.
But it was awesome.
Last year.
One of the sites we went to see was, you went there, the tomb.
Uh-huh.
The grave site.
Yeah, but it was a waste of time.
Yeah.
It's empty.
Is it? Yeah.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the trip. Our school, you know,
nice
when
nice
is it?
Garden though.
Oh yes,
yeah,
nice garden.
Nice
yeah.
Garden, but the
was, it was fun. You
there
know,
was there was two Japanese ladies and some other old lady in there. That's all that was in the tomb when I went in there.
So I enjoyed the trip to the Holy Land, Israel. I had been to the tomb. I've seen in it, inside, outside, and guess what? The tomb is empty.
It is not there.
There it is. It's empty, just like that. Just like that. The Bible tells us, so we can believe that.
Amen.
Why do we always have to believe what so-and-so said?
Mm.
We can believe so-and-so, don't know what they're talking about,
right.
and we can't believe
right.
what the Word of God tells us.
Uh-huh.
Come on now.
Mm-hmm.
So-and-so says this is going to happen, or that's going to happen, or it didn't happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we said, well, you know, where did you hear that? Well, so-and-so said, and we're going to believe so-and-so, but we can't believe what the Word of God said. I said, show me. Can you show me scripture? No. So-and-so said, and what so-and-so says, I mean, that's the truth. That's, you know, you can take it to the bank.
Yeah.
Is that right? Well, if it's not in the Word of God, you can just put it on the shelf and forget about it. Or just press delete and let it go.
Yeah.
Amen.
Praise God.
So, the Word tells us that He is risen. The world has proved, but they can't explain it.
Mm-hmm.
He is the only one true God that is risen from the dead.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. To the world, Easter is just another holiday, time off, 3-day weekend, lots of fun, no work, party time, entertainment, foods, barbecue, travel, vacation, Easter break.
Yeah.
Used to be Easter break, now it's just a spring break.
Yeah.
We don't want nothing to associate that with a godly thing, you know.
That's it.
So it's no longer Easter break, it's just a spring break. Easter means nothing. Has nothing to do with our God, trying to get God out of everything, out of the schools, and the prisons are full. And you get them to prison, and they break out the Bibles.
Yeah.
If you break them out in high school, maybe they wouldn't end up in prison.
Right. Amen.
Amen. Praise God, but no, there's no God like our God. Amen.
Right.
Praise God. Resurrection to believers is this. Jesus rose from the dead. Jesus paid the price in full.
Yes.
For all. And of course, John 3:16. You know, if you want to know what love is, this is true love.
Yes.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
Yes.
And we're talking about agape love.
Yes.
Unconditional. He didn't hold it against us.
That's right.
He just sacrificed his Son for us to have a chance to have salvation and receive it. Celebrating the resurrection. This is for us. Victory over death, hell, and the grave. And salvation, a free gift. A lot of people don't even know this. Salvation is free.
Yes,
you have to do, only thing you have to do is confess it, receive it. Amen.
Amen.
But if you don't do it, you ain't going anywhere.
Yep.
It's just like you could be full of the Word of God going somewhere to happen. But if you don't release the Word, ain't nothing going to happen. Because remember, words are carriers of life or death.
Yeah.
Words are carriers, positive or negative. Whatever you, words are seeds. Whatever you plant is going to grow. If you go around planting the bad seed, negative seeds, this is what you're going to grow in your garden.
Yeah.
But if you go around planting good seed, the Word of God, you're going to reap good things.
Amen.
Amen. So you are your gardener there. You got to plant good seed everywhere you go, everything you do.
Amen.
Make sure you plant the right seed.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you can't blame nobody but yourself.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And that's why he said, you know what, renew your mind so you can keep planting the good seed and not the negative seed. Amen. Because the enemy's going to come always to steal, kill, and destroy. Amen. He attacks the mind the most.
Yes.
The battlefield is the mind.
It is the mind.
Amen.
Yeah.
And you know, my mind goes away.
Mm-hmm.
My mind starts thinking the bad things.
Yeah.
And you cross me, or you pull in front of me, or you say something to me, the first thing is, I'm flesh. I'm flesh, but then all of a sudden, my mind, my soul, my mind, will, and emotions, my spirit, pops up and says, remember what the Word of God says.
Yeah.
Remember what Jesus did for you.
Yes, amen.
So now I've got to correct myself.
Mm-hmm.
I got to correct myself. If I have no Word in me, guess what? The flesh is going to dominate.
Yes, it will.
But if you feed your spirit and renew your mind with the Word of God, now your flesh has to take a break and say, hey, lay down, sit. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And you, those things will dominate your walk with him. Amen. Praise God. And the Bible tells us in Galatians, the flesh and the spirit fighting all the time. They fight all the time. The flesh wants his way.
Yeah.
The spirit says, no, we're not having that anymore.
No,
we've changed our ways. We're not going there anymore.
Oh,
amen. And the enemy knows to send the right people to distract you.
Oh, yeah.
And he knows how to send the right distractions to distract you and pull you away.
Yeah.
These are new beginnings for a new life. I received him as my Lord and Savior.
Uh-huh.
So now he's got a new beginning for you. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says that you're a new creature in Christ.
New creature. Amen.
Amen. I don't have to go there anymore. I don't have to do that anymore. I'm a new person in Christ.
Yes.
Now I can be his ambassador. Now I can be his minister of reconciliation, going somewhere, administering for him and doing for him. Amen. Past forgiving. Past is forgiven. Start a new life with him. Amen.
Amen.
Here's people's worldly gods and heroes. Muhammad, he's still in the grave. Buddha, Allah, Confucius, Hitler, Joseph Smith, Jim Jones, David Koresh, all have died and are still dead.
Yeah.
And they never rose and never will rise until Judgment Day.
Yes.
Amen. Jesus died, but he rose on the third day. We serve the risen Savior, a risen King, and a risen Lord.
Yeah.
You know what a profound thing to be made, Jesus says, but he says, you know what? I am, in John 14:6 says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody goes to the Father except through me. You as a believer, as a Christian, needs to know this, okay? There's no other way to Jesus or to the Father except through Jesus. So if you want Jesus, you have to receive him as your Lord and Savior.
Yeah.
Amen. Be saved. Receive him. And now I can lead others to Christ. I can lead others to the Father. How do I know they're going to get to the Father? Because they received Jesus as Lord and Savior. Amen. People ask, why was the stone rolled away? The stone was not rolled away for Jesus to come out.
Right.
As a matter of fact, they plotted this. You know, they plotted this with the king and says, you know what? If we don't block the grave or the cave, the tomb, they're going to steal the body and say as their God rose.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to be in trouble. Well, they were in trouble anyway.
Yeah.
But the stone, the stone was not rolled away for Jesus to come out. Amen.
That's right.
The stone was rolled away so that we could see that he wasn't there.
That's right.
Amen. And we're going to read that in a few minutes. The tomb is great evidence of the resurrection of Jesus. Amen. So praise God. He's alive today and forevermore.
Yeah.
Critics tried and explained and haven't been able to. Mm-hmm. So praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
I'm going to read you the story here quickly. Jesus paid a price. Keep going. Next one. John the Baptist introduced Jesus. Behold, he says, he was baptizing, and then all of a sudden he says, behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Keep going. Yeshua, the Passover Lamb. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And I gave it to you in Spanish. Cuando Juan vio a Jesús, dijo, aquí el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Juan 1:29. El Cordero sin defecto que era sacrificado todos los días por remisión de los pecados. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, el Cordero de Dios. Praise God.
Yes.
Amen. So, hey, praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're going to read it from John 20, the chapter 20 and verses 1 through 31. Talks about the resurrection and the empty tomb. Amen. You can follow along. I'm going to read it to you from the New Living Translation. But it goes like this. Early on Sunday morning, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and found that the stone had been rolled away from the entrance. She ran and found Simon Peter and the other disciples whom Jesus loved. She says, they have taken the Lord's body out of the tomb, and we don't know where they put him. Peter and the other disciples started out for the tomb. They were both running, but the other disciples outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He stooped and looked in and saw linen wrappings laying there, but he didn't go in. Then Simon Peter arrived and went inside. He also noticed that the linen wrappings lay in there. But when they roll you in these things, you know, I mean, they pretty tight. He tried to explain how Lazarus came out of the body when Jesus told him to come out. If he was wrapped tight and his arms and legs are wrapped tight, how was Lazarus able to come out of there? But he came.
Yes.
He came. Amen. He came out of there. Jesus' wrappings were on the ground. Except, now verse 7 says this, while the cloth that had covered Jesus' head was folded and laying apart from other wrappings.
Yes.
Then the disciples who had reached the tomb first also went in as he saw and believed. Mm-hmm. Now verse 9, for until they still hadn't understood the scriptures that said Jesus must rise from the dead.
Yeah.
Then they went home. They went home. Jesus appeared to Mary Magdalene. Mary was standing outside the tomb crying. Mm-hmm. And as she wept, she stood and looked in. She saw two white robed angels, mm-hmm. one sitting at the head and the other sitting at the foot of the place where the body of Jesus had been laying. Dear woman, why are you crying? The angel asked her. Because they have taken my Lord. She replied, and I don't know where they put him. Verse 14 says, she turned to leave and saw someone standing there. It was Jesus, but she did not recognize him. Says, dear woman, why are you crying? Jesus asked her. What are you looking for? Who are you looking for? She thought it was the gardener. Sir, she says, if you have taken him away, tell me where you have put him. I will go and get him. Mary, Jesus says. She turned to him and cried out, Rabboni, which is Hebrew for teacher. He says, don't cling, don't touch me, Jesus says, for I haven't yet ascended to the Father. But go find your brothers and tell them I am ascending to my Father and your Father and to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene found the disciples and told them, I have seen the Lord. Then she gave them his message. Jesus appeared to the disciples on verse 19. Then Sunday evening, the disciples were meeting behind locked doors because they were afraid of the Jewish leaders. Suddenly, Jesus is standing there among them. Peace be with you, he says. As he spoke, he showed them the wounds in his hands and his side. They were filled with joy when they saw the Lord. Again, he says, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you.
Yes.
Amen. You put your name there. Mm. He is sending us, okay?
Yes.
Verse 22, then he breathed on them and says, receive the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
23, if you forgive anyone's sin, they are forgiven.
Yes.
If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven. So, verse 24, one of the 12 disciples, Thomas, nicknamed the twin, was not with the others when Jesus came. They told him, we have seen the Lord. He replied, I won't believe it unless I see the nail wounds in his hands and put my fingers into them and place my hand in the wound in his side. And a lot of us, we got to be careful because I won't believe it unless I see it.
Okay,
we got just like Dalton Thomas. I hate to have that placed on me. He said, well, Dalton Jose over there. Verse 26 says, 8 days later, the disciples were together again. Remember, locked doors, closed doors. And this time, Thomas was with them. The doors were locked. But suddenly, as before, Jesus was standing among them. Peace be with you, he says. Verse 27. Then he said to Thomas, how do you know Thomas says this, huh? The disciples didn't tell him. He just knew what Thomas says. And he walked right up to Thomas and says, he didn't say, he just says, peace be with you. But then he went right to Thomas. He says, put your fingers here and look at my hands and put your hand into this wound on my side. Don't be faithless any longer. Believe. And of course, Thomas tries to make up for all this.
Yeah.
He says, my Lord, my God, Thomas explained. Then Jesus told him, you believe because you have seen.
Uh-huh.
Because you have seen me. Blessed are those who believe without seeing me.
Yes.
We, as children that have not seen him, we haven't seen him physically, but we've seen him through his word.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We see him in his word.
Yes.
And you're not going to see him and you're not going to hear him unless you open the Bible, the word of God, and read it and get
yes.
it in you. Amen.
Yes.
Because the only thing that can stop the enemy is the word.
Yeah.
Amen. It's a defeated foe.
Yeah.
But you got to use the word of God to
yes.
do what the Lord's called you to do.
That's
you can't
right.
do it by yourself.
That's right.
Money or anything else except through his word. Amen.
Yes.
Do it his way.
His way.
Amen. Not your way.
Mm-hmm.
There's no other way. You know, too many churches out there saying, hey, we got the new thing.
Yeah.
Ain't no new thing.
That's
it's all
it.
Right here. Yeah. From cover to cover. It's the word of God. Amen. So if you're going somewhere where you say they got the new thing, just like the world, always coming out with new stuff. Ain't nothing new about the word of God. It's the same. It worked then, it'll work now.
That's
amen.
Right.
So praise God. Only thing new yeah. about the word is this is the first time you read it.
Yeah.
Only thing new about it maybe is you're reading a different translation.
Uh-huh.
You know, there's nothing wrong with that.
Uh-huh.
But once you get it in you,
yes.
you gotta let it out. Just like a spring, that living water coming
yes.
out. Amen.
Amen.
So this book, the disciples saw Jesus do many other miraculous signs in addition to the ones recorded in this book.
Yes.
But these were written so that many continue to believe that Jesus
yes.
is the Messiah, the Son
yes.
of God, and that by believing in him, you will have life by the power of his name.
Amen.
Amen. So basically, I'm done there.
Praise God.
Keep going. Behold the Lamb of God.
Yes.
Amen. Isaiah 53:7, he says, he was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shears is silent.
Yeah.
So he opened not his mouth. He was yeah. silent. Go ahead.
That's the last one.
Okay, thank you. So why did Jesus fold a napkin? Let me, in the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verse 7, you can read that anytime. But let me read you this quick little thing, and then we're done. In order to understand the significance of the folded napkin, you have to understand a little bit about the Hebrew tradition of the day. The folded napkin had to do with the master and the servant and every Jewish boy in this tradition. Basically, the servant served the master and he stayed away. When the master was finished, if he was finished, he wadded up his napkin and threw it and left it on the table. Wadded up napkin meaning I am not coming back. So the servant message was you can clean the master's space. Okay, if he got up to go somewhere and he folded his napkin meaning I'll be back, I'm coming back. So the servant stayed back and didn't mess with the master's plate.
That's right.
Amen. He's coming back. I'm going to hold back. Okay,
yes.
So Jesus, before he left,
yes.
he took that napkin that was covering his head,
yes.
covering his face, and he took all the other linen cloths
mm-hmm.
were wadded up
yeah.
on the floor, except for the one over his face.
Yeah.
He folded that and he placed
hallelujah.
It.
Hallelujah, amen.
Thank
meaning,
you,
our meaning is he's coming back.
Yes, thank
amen.
You, Lord.
So he's coming back, so we need to be about the Father's business,
amen.
Doing what he's
amen.
Called us to do, knowing that our God is coming back. So
yeah.
regardless of what's going on, what's happening, or whatever, We just be busy about the Lord's business. Yes. Amen. So listen, if you never had a chance to receive Him as Lord and Savior, all you have to do, I've done the same thing, you know. I've sinned, confess your sins, repent, and press on with Him. Yes. You say, Lord, I receive you as my Lord and Savior, and He's going to come, and He's going to be your Lord and Savior. And you have salvation. And now you can start living for Him. You go find your Bible. Go to a place where they teach the Word of God. Yes. And start learning the Word of God. Amen.
Yes.
And start doing for Him. And once you get the Word, more Word to get in you.
Uh-huh.
So people can't distract you and say,
right.
You know, this is not true. It is true because it's in His Word. And now you know the truth. The Bible says the truth is going to set you free.
Yeah.
Amen. From whatever the world has to say, whatever people have to say.
Yeah.
Amen. And I'm going to press on, and He's got a special mission for you. Amen. So press on with Him, church. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
I think, Miss, I'm done. Basically.